Let me first thank those who have spoken here today. I'm going to be very brief. I know it's my colleagues are saying, no, he's not. But let me, I'm going to be very brief because I think it's important.
Who are you?
Right. That's right. My name is Mario Diaz-Balart, and it's a privilege to be here. Rabbi, thank you for your hospitality in this house of worship and of hope. Thank you once again for the Faith and Politics Institute. You're right, Joe. We keep thanking them, but we have to continue thanking them. And Joe Crowley, who has not only been instrumental in putting this together, he's been a tour guide, he's been an inspiration, and has really made us all feel exceedingly at home. Thank you. Thank you. The reason I am going to be brief is because I think it's important that we kind of take in what we've heard this weekend. So all I'm going to do is just thank a few people. One of the people that I most admire, in this time of partisan bickering, it may sound strange, but one of the people that I most admire, because he has become, in my eyes, the one who is emblematic for the cause of immigrants. All of you are so important. All my colleagues, I'm so grateful that you're here. But this man, to me, has become a real hero. Luis Gutierrez. And while I'm thanking people, I don't know how to thank him and his lovely wife. Eric Cantor is not a friend of mine, of my family's. He's a brother. We heard a little bit about his story today. Let me see if I can get through this. You know, my brother served in Congress as well. That's where we got to know her. He lost a son. Eric, you know, the majority leader of the House, is there anybody busier than that, my colleagues, right? The majority leader of the House, traveling and working and fundraising and, you know, getting people yelling at him and all the things that the majority leader does. And my brother is no longer in Congress, and he lost his son this year. And Eric was in Palm Beach County. You all who know Florida, we live in Miami. It's about 2 hours away. You know what Eric did? With Diane. Quietly. Drove down 2 hours to spend an hour with Lincoln and Christina. Get him out. Thank you. So, we heard Eric's story. That's part of the Eric Cantor story as well. So again, to me, what a fitting way to earn to finish this pilgrimage that has been a pilgrimage of history, of learning, and of love, than to be in a house of worship in a town, which, by the way, when I was driving through, I thought, hey, dude, this is Miami. Very similar to Miami. And finally hearing from folks who have dedicated their lives to help others, to serve, which is a big part of what America is, which is, I think, a big part of what the immigrant history is of America. And again, finally, hearing from the story of a person, of Eric Cantor, who's a majority leader, and you say potentially the first one to ever come here, a majority leader who not only loves his country, like we all do, who has an incredible story, like every immigrant has, but who has unlimited love for his colleagues, for his friends. For him, the country is not this weird thing. It's individuals and families. I can say that because we've lived it. And finally, as I said, I was going to be brief because I wanted to make sure that we all are able to absorb what we've heard. And I've learned a lot, by the way, this weekend. To think about who we are, why we come here, and how who we are and why we come here has allowed us to be this incredible nation, one nation under God. What a blessing to have been part of this great weekend. Thank you very much.